All right, here we are for the finals, round three. We are on the draw. And the sand is probably bad. If this was a scry land, I think I would keep. Because then we'd at least have all of our colors, and like we just hit a mountain, and then we can cast basically our whole hand. And we could even play Abbott to try and hit an extra land. But I think, as is, I'm going to mull. It's pretty close, though. This hand is really bad, too. I'll mull again. Alright, well, if we draw mountain, then... I don't know. This hand is certainly not good, either. Okay, well, that's something. Not quite a mountain, because we can't cast Chain of the Rocks, but at least we are going to be able to cast some of our spells. Looks like we're up against blue-white control, maybe. Yeah, definitely. This matchup's usually, I think, pretty good, because they really don't have any good answers to Stormbreath Dragon once it hits play. Alright. We're kind of doing it. I guess I'll cast this Whirling Outburst. Yeah. We'll jam another Whirling Outburst. Hopefully this one makes it through. Nope. Narset, okay. Interesting. And swing and a miss. Well, Narset does have a lot of loyalty. Does have that going for it. It's a Clash of Wills, and that's probably... He missed a land last turn, so that's almost certainly the card that was revealed with Narset before. Yeah, I mean, I guess we have to work through this Narset. So I'm just going to go after it with everything we got. I don't think we're going to get any better Lightning Strike targets anyway, so... Could get Clash of Will, even. This also prevents any flashback shenanigans, or at least means that Narset has to die if he wants to flashback, like a whatever, dig or what have you, which is probably what's getting cast here. I think we're probably dead. Mulling to five in a matchup like this where we're already somewhat behind because all of our removal is dead in game one is pretty rough. He's gonna plus Narset. Miss, but probably cast like an Elspeth or something this turn. Yeah. Okay, this is not going to be easy. So I guess we play Swift Spear and stoke Narset to death. And then I'm not really sure how we're ever going to beat this Elspeth. We're not going to. I'm just going to concede. We're definitely just not beating this Elspeth at all. Yeah, those are not going to get it done. Alright, so I think we want Revoke. Probably just one, though. I'm going to cut the burn spells. Actually, I'm going to cut Chain to the Rocks, I guess, over the burn spells. Soulfire. Man, I have not played against the decks I was expecting to play against. I guess Lightning Strike and Wild Slash can stay in some small amounts. Could have Ojutai, which would make Valorous Stance valuable. Maybe I'll bring in one stance. Because it can still save our guys, so there's something to be said for that. And again, the one Revoke is I'm not sure if it's good or not. I don't really know enough about what's in our opponent's deck. It's a little bit off the radar. But I'm going to try it. And let's give this a whirl. Alright, here we are for game two. We get to go first. This hand is bad, but I don't want to mulligan it. It's not that bad. I think Outburst is one of our better cards, too, because it kind of necessitates a big board clear. So if he doesn't have turn two Clash of Wills for it, then things are going to be rough. Definitely want to top that Storm Breath. I think sort of our game plan one is to resolve a Storm Breath Dragon that probably just wins the game by itself. Alright, another Outburst is not bad. We can just keep jamming things. Like, this is probably going to get Clash of Willed. Oh, negate? Okay, sure. He's casting a Jace. Sure thing. So we can go Outburst, stoke your Jace. It seems like a good little turn. Don't really want to just play Storm Breath into all this open mana. Think I would probably be comfortable playing Soulfire into it. Like, I don't mind if Soulfire gets countered, that's for sure. And then if he has to use a Wrath to clear this sort of medium-sized board presence we have, then hopefully, then does not have one for Storm Breath. Anticipate, that's fine. Smells like a Wrath. Ugh, that card. Pretty annoying, actually. Now I think we have to just jam our Storm Breath and hope for the best, even though it's probably not going to be good enough. Probably going to get Wrath now. Well, maybe not. I assume it would have happened already if it was going to happen. Does this thing target? Each opponent does not target. Sweet. Okay. Well, he doesn't have a Wrath. And yeah, I think I'm just going to play Rabble Master. Put a card on bottom, so probably going to dig for a Wrath, and then hopefully the second Storm Breath can mop up. I like playing Rabble Master because even though the tokens don't actually deal any damage, the Rabble Master itself will hit pretty hard. Okay, so yeah, probably has Anticipate into Dig, which almost assuredly will find a Wrath. I actually think thinking about it more, I should have saved this Rabble Master, because what's going to happen is we're going to get Wrathed. That's like the only way we're not just going to win. If he doesn't have Wrath, we're just going to win. So I should have tried to play around it. So what's going to happen is he's going to Wrath us. And then we're going to untap and play a Storm Breath, and then if he untaps and plays an Elspeth, we really would like to have a Rabble Master to follow that up with, because Orbs of Warding doesn't actually save the Planeswalkers. Yep. So we kind of have to just hope for no Elspeth then. Yeah, it was definitely bad for me to play the Rabble Master. Although, if there is no Elspeth or second wrap, then we're just going to win easily, I think. Yeah, Ojutai's Command is probably not going to get the job done. We're going to Monstrous Storm Breath, which is going to deal a decent chunk of damage. And then we'll hit for 6. Our opponent's at 2. And really needs something to answer this Storm Breath. Found the Elspeth. Okay, so that does narrow our range of outs quite a bit, actually. He is still a 2, so like Ashcloud Phoenix probably gets it done. Although now the counter magic wall is probably up, I have to assume. Lightning Strike, unfortunately, does not get it done because he has Hexproof. But Ashcloud Phoenix can win the game. Oh no, it can't win the game immediately because of stupid Orbs of Warding. Yeah, we're probably just going to lose. If I had held the Rabble Master, then the Elspeth would be dead and we'd have a Rabble Master in play right now. So, I definitely did not play this game as well as I could have. I also think that a third Revoke should be in our sideboard, because this card has actually just become very popular. Played against it a few times now. And it's pretty problematic. Okay. That narrows down our win conditions considerably. Play this card that doesn't do anything. I have to assume our opponent also has like a Dissolve or two in hand at this point in the game. I'm pretty disappointed with the way I played this. Oh, well, I could have fizzled that last breath, but it doesn't really matter. Take 7. Okay. If we were going to win, that was how it starts, I think. But I can't imagine this resolves. Oh, it did. Alright. It's lucky. So, we can't really block here. Because we actually take... Because then we can't flip up. And we need to flip up if we want to have any chance at winning. So we're drawing to another Storm Breath, potentially. Assuming our opponent just has nothing, which seems kind of unlikely. We're drawing to another Storm Breath. Or a Revoke Existence. Or another Ash Cloud. Or I guess Sarkhan. So like 2, 3, 4, yeah, not a lot of outs. Yeah, that's not going to do it. Well, that was rough. I definitely threw this game. Like, if we had had more time because the Elspeth was dead, I think we would have had a much better chance. But I punted it, so there you go. Obviously, this was just game 2, so there's no guarantee we would have won game 3. But thanks for watching, and I'll be back next week.